We're back with another Total Transformation in this week's Homes with Heather. I'm so happy to welcome back Heather Kane from Kane Premier Properties. Good morning. Great to see you
once again. Thank you.
I feel like every time we visit, I learn something new about you. And I was just telling you about my history and how I lost a home to a flood. You actually have, and speaking of flood, along with that comes mold. You actually have a background in mold remediation.
I do. You know, when I graduated from college, that was my first job out of college. And that's really when the love for homes and construction really began, is I actually did indoor air quality testing and helped homeowners that had experienced water damage and the steps and the processes of what to do to remediate correctly. And what I found out is that really, you know, once you've remediated mold correctly, you're 100% safe and fine. Yeah. And so it was just that reassuring that homeowner.
I could have used you a few years ago for that, because until you see that firsthand, it's hard to understand how damaging water can be.
It can, you know,
especially
and just a
to your
little
homes.
Bit of water.
So what are those first steps? You know, after we're post-Hurricane Irma here, I know people in the area have had some water damage, and what are those first steps if we're dealing with this situation that we should take?
Absolutely. The first step is really determining where the water source is coming from. I mean, the most important thing is stopping the water source, because, and you know, we're still in that rainy season this time of year. So really making sure that you locate it and then you sever that water source. So if it is a roof leak, make sure you have those tarps on the roof and make sure they're secured. But then also, because mold can't really grow without moisture. And so we just have to make sure that that's stopped. The next thing is making sure you get a professional in, because the last thing you want to do is remove sheetrock in a home that has mold growing on it without proper containment, and making sure that you do the indoor air quality testing. Indoor air quality testing is good to do in the beginning, so you kind of have that baseline of what is going on in the home, so that way when it's remediated and then you test again, you can make sure that it's remediated correctly and then there's no more mold spores in the home.
Yeah, absolutely. And like I said, if you take care of it the right way, as you said,
you do,
you can come out on ahead and
you
feel
can,
good about it.
And mold is not scary. I always tell my homeowners, you know, I like when I know that there's been mold in a home, it actually makes me reassured purchasing it, because there's usually indoor air quality testing to show that it's been remediated correctly. Where otherwise, you know, we live in Florida, there's moisture everywhere, and you always
kind of
are going to find mold.
Yeah. Well, let's talk about insurance for a second, because I know a lot of times, hopefully you are covered, but a lot of times people aren't. What do we need to know about that?
Yeah, you know, the thing is with Florida is insurance coverage, you know, a lot of people didn't have it, because areas flood in Florida that did not, I mean, they hadn't had flooded in 100, 150 years. So every insurance policy is different. You know, I highly recommend anyone to always get flood insurance on their home, no matter where you live. We are in Florida, and it's important to have.
Very insightful. Thank you so much, Heather. Great to see you, as always. If someone wants to learn more as we close here about Kane Premier Properties, what can they do?
Yes, please go to our website, KanePremierProperties.com/Fox4.
And be sure to head online to our website as well. We will have this interview with Heather posted on our website at Fox4MorningBlend.com.